Ew. Hello everybody and welcome back to Let's Play Genshin Impact. I didn't play yesterday. Well, I did in the like early morning hours. It's currently 2:45 a.m. on Wednesday, the 11th of August. Wait, shit. Oh, never mind. Okay. So I have to get my daily stuff done within like the next hour. Well, basically what happened was I didn't have work again tonight. That's three nights in a row. But I took that opportunity to actually, instead of like rush through playing Genshin for 10 hours straight, and instead of uploading, I just slept for like 10 hours because I haven't actually gotten a lot of sleep recently. I've just had little spurts of 2 to 3 hours of sleep, even though I've been off of work, because I wanted to play Genshin and I wanted to do other stuff. So my body was like, but we're back, and oh my god, did I have a freaking frustrating night last night. For once, it has nothing to do with work either. It all started with my YouTube channel. So YouTube is denying me monetization now on every video on my channel, of like 12,000 plus videos on my channel. And the reason is so frustrating because it has nothing to do with me. It's not my fault. About 3 months ago, so I don't use AdSense to earn money on my channel. I go through a network. But that network needs access to my AdSense account, okay? So long story short, about 3-4 months ago, I got a notification that said I would need to verify my AdSense account by entering a PIN that they would send me in the mail. Now, I fucking hate it when anything has to be sent through the physical mail, because that shit like this happens. It never came. Now, it says that it could take 2 to 4 weeks to arrive. So you're telling me I gotta wait up to a month for a fucking piece of mail to arrive just to keep my account verified so that I can earn money on my videos? But okay, whatever. I sent for it. It never arrived. Okay? So I went and I got another one sent to me, because you can resend it up to, like, I think three or four times. Okay? It sent it, or says it was sent. Again, month passes by. Nothing came in the mail. Rinse and repeat. To right now, I still have never received a single piece of mail from YouTube or Google or whoever was supposed to be sending it about my AdSense account. Not once. And now, I have been punished, and they've disabled all monetization on my entire channel. That includes my Genshin Impact videos, which makes me the most money. Thankfully, I don't live off of my YouTube channel, but it does give me extra spending cash. Some of the polls I've done in the past on Genshin Impact were because I've used the money I've earned from making Genshin videos and didn't actually use like my saving funds. So I'm, needless to say, not very fucking happy that something I have no control over, because they can't fucking send it in the mail to me, and it has never showed up 2, 3, 4 times that I've had it sent, I'm the one who's getting punished for it, and there is no alternative. When you go through their PIN troubleshooting system that they have right there on their website, you're like, okay, that's fine. Maybe you can just send me an email. You know, I mean, why the fuck can't you send me a fucking email about it? Or what about a text? Or what if you need like 2 or 3 step authentication? Just send me an email that sends it to a text, or send a text that sends it through an email. That way you know that it's going through me 2 or 3 times so that you know it's me. Nope. You go through that troubleshooting and all it says is it'll repeat itself. It says, well, sometimes it can take a little while because COVID might be, you know, delaying it. You're telling me that my first letter has been delayed by 4 months now? Is that what you're trying to tell me? You're fucking insane. And let's just say I'm really, really, really unhappy about that. Thankfully, like I said, I don't live off of my YouTube, so I'm not going to just stop uploading because I'm not earning money on it. It's still very much a hobby for me. But this shouldn't be happening in the first place. I contacted my network last night, and I'm waiting for a response from them. Hopefully we can get something figured out, because this is ridiculous. So yeah, that put me in a pretty fucking bad mood last night. And then to top it off, I had a friend who went and threw $300 at this game, plus played for like 20 hours straight just to get the sword, the Mist Splitter sword, the one that we ended up pulling on our weapon banner within the first 80 pulls or whatever. I wasn't very happy with them at all, because they don't have that kind of money to spend, you know, and they don't have that kind of time either. I tried explaining to them that the Mist Splitter, it'll come back. You know, it'll repeat in a future banner. It's, you know, you have, they have Ayaka. So, at least they have the character who goes corresponds with the sword. You know, it's not the end of the world. And apparently, I guess, I really did get lucky when I got the Mist Splitter on my first go, because when they played, they got... I think they got the pole arm. They got a 5-star weapon, and then when they hit the pity again, they ended up getting the pole arm and not the Mist Splitter. And then, of course, by that point, they were guaranteed. But there was only, I think, 3 hours left by that point to get pity again. So they went and threw $200 at the game just to get the sword. And I was like, you know, we've all spent a lot of money on games before, but I'm not very happy with the fact that you decided to do that. Because, like I said, they don't have that kind of money to spend. And now they're kind of suffering because of what they did. So that didn't help with my frustrations last night either. But thankfully, that was pretty much everything. And of course, me not going to work caused issues with my family. It's like, my fucking choice, okay? I can take time off of work if I fucking want to. It doesn't matter when I take it off. It's not gonna kill nobody. But I'm here now. Let me breathe. Now, I did actually log in last night, and I did claim my 90 primigems for the daily Welkin Moon thing. So just so that, since you didn't see that here, I already did that. Because I said that I was going to log in, and I was going to use a notebook and try to get everything down that I wanted to do, because I was getting overwhelmed. Well, I tried to do that, and then I got overwhelmed from doing that. I managed to write down all of Hu Tao's information, exactly how many materials I need to hit Hu Tao's final ascension, as well as the death match's final ascension. But obviously we don't have access to that until we hit Adventure Rank 50. So I was then going to do the next character and then the next character, but it took me like 40 minutes just to do Hu Tao, so I just said, fuck it. You know, we'll just have to wing it, right? Okay, so first of all, let's take a look. So we got some bullshit here. So we've got the new update thing, which brings with it new banners and such, which of course is the ones that I'm going to want to pull on. So right here they are. So the other banners are officially over. So in the weapon banner, oh here, let's go and look at this. It's charting a course. Well, I'd rather chart course for that. Chart course, okay. One thing I do want to mention about this, I'm not probably going to pull on this at all, mind you. I'm just charting the course because there's an exclamation mark. One thing I wanted to mention here is that I was told during my pull episode, a lot of people posted comments saying the fate points do not carry over. So like with a character banner where your pity and stuff kind of carries over or resets depending on your 5-star pulls, that doesn't happen here. You can get 2 fate points for the weapon and not get the weapon and then just miss the event and say, oh, well, I can get the next one then. And it'll reset each time, which is ridiculous. Oh my god, you know. And then of course here we've got the new character banner, which has 2 new characters in it that I'm interested in getting. And then we've got 2 characters we already have, 1 character that I have no idea how to feel about, and then 1 character that I think is really cute but we've never played with. So this is what I've basically been kind of saving up for with my primigems. We don't have a lot right now. I mean, we have a few, but we don't have enough to even come close to getting a 5-star, not unless some god tier luck started to occur. Let's see. Is this our daily login thing? Yeah, it is. So this is going to be a bit tricky doing this all in 1 hour. Oh, right. Oh, I was going to look up Ayaka. I was going to look up to see what her talents cost so I know which of these to pick. I can do that on my phone after we figure this shit out. Okay, now what the hell is this? Oh, we got new test runs. Oh, look at that. It's a... I thought it said naked weed. Of course. Of course I would think that. And here's another new character right here. Ooh, another new type. Crystal Marrow. Ew. Bellowing Blaze. Hey shit, it gives you the red crystals. But you gotta fight the Pyro Cube. I don't think we've ever fought a Pyro Cube before. Okay, so let me see. We've got dailies, right? Yeah, let's go ahead and do those real quick. So yeah, anyways, guys, I needed to rant quick, because, man, oh man, and my room is, like, flooding. Oh, and by the way, I actually was going to play last night, like, yesterday around 5 or 6 p.m., but when I sat down to get ready to play, because I had published, I think, up to the video where I fight the the god of vortexes or whatever the hell his name was, when the Jade Chamber gets sacrificed. That's what episode I'm up to in uploading right now. But when I had published that, a storm rolled in, like a big nasty storm rolled in. So I had to stop what I was doing and wait. And the reason I had to do that was because, well, not only was the storm a bit of a powerful one, so I wanted to make sure I was aware of my surroundings the whole time, but I also didn't want the power going out, and holy shit, was it flickering. It didn't go out, thankfully, but it flickered quite a bit. So that got in the way. That lasted a couple hours. Okay. Die. Oh, he's dead.
Hello.
Oh shit. You're an ass, you know that? So, I've been reading lots of comments, obviously, that have been posted. One of the comments said, you know, that I keep healing Hu Tao instead of waiting for her health to drop, and when her health is below 50% or whatever, I get that pyro bonus, so I'm actively kind of like ruining my bonus, which is true. The reason I keep healing her is just because, like, it's just a habit to keep my characters healed. Especially on bosses, because when a boss can one-shot you, some of the bosses in this game can do that. I don't want Hu Tao being low on health and then accidentally letting her get killed just because I wanted to get the bonus pyro damage. I just feel like I will end up getting that bonus pyro damage as a battle progresses, because at some point her health is going to drop far enough anyways. But alas, maybe not. Okay, our first daily has been completed. Get some tree wood. Yeah, I didn't even get any of my stuff ready to go. I don't know if I'm going to take work off this whole week or if I'm just going to go in tonight. I mean, I've set myself back 3 days by taking time off, but... well, fuck it, you know. It's not that I've set myself back, really. Like, if I spent money, then I'm losing profit, basically. And I have to make up for that, so I have to add days on. But if I just don't go to work and don't spend money, then I'm basically kind of stalemating my goal. So nothing falls behind, but it's not moving forward either. So I think that's fine, at least. Now, I need a lot of that nectar stuff, like a shitload of that nectar. So I should probably fight the bitch creature that's over here. I might even have to go hunting for bitch creatures. Is this an icy or... oh, it's a fiery one. Okay. Fiery wheel. Oh, mean chop. Man, I wish I could do an LP on the game. I could. I went through all that time and got an Elgato game capture for Christmas 1 year, and whoops, I didn't mean to use that. And I was so ready to just record all of my childhood games on consoles, and then I only ever recorded like two, I think, to this day. One PS3 game and one PS2 game. Can you come over here? I don't want him so close to the edge, because then he'll fall off. Can I get him to root? Oh, of course not. Fine, fuck you. Don't you dare teleport back up here then, bitch. Okay, he's dead. La 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 la. Oh shit. Fuck, I was gonna do a thing to him. Alright, come here, everyone! Come here! Yes! That's a good little group of boys. Oh, it's all you, isn't it? Well, Hutao kinda still rapes. Even though enemies are a lot tankier. Oh, you bitch! Oh, right, there's another thing that I gotta talk about that's kind of interesting, actually. So someone was explaining that Barbara has a 5-star burst animation. And I didn't know what the hell that meant. Because apparently in the beta, they used to be a 5-star, but were changed to a 4-star. So apparently, the burst animations actually are based off of... Shit, hold on. I'm losing my train of thought. Okay, apparently character animations for their bursts are actually based off of whether or not the character is 4-star or 5-star. So, I guess, to my understanding, a 5-star character animation is, you know, you'll see them, like, look at the camera, it'll zoom in on them, they'll be more animated, kind of like a little mini cutscene type of a deal. But a 4-star character won't. So they use, like, Noelle as an example. Like, when I use Hu Tao or Barbara, you'll notice that it zooms right up on their face, they have a little play animation, but when I use Noelle, she just kind of swings her sword and it turns gold, you know? It doesn't really, you know, or like when they also use Xiang Ling as an example. When I used her, all she does is poop out a little fire nado and that's it. It doesn't actually have an animation for it. So, I thought that was kind of interesting, a little detail that I never noticed before. I'm assuming all 5-star characters have it, and that's why it's called a 5-star character animation, but I am not for certain on that. Okay, so that's this area done then. Just collecting my wood, man. Is that the time trial one? I think it's that time trial one. You've done this one a lot. Holy nipples. As well as making potions, you can shit. Are my expedition? My expedition rewards ready? Yeah. My expedition rewards ready? Going through the processes once more, you know? It's like, don't fall off there.
Like, man, we've watched you do these 22 times now in the series.
Like, oh, stop climbing stuff, Hotel. Just open it. Okay. Oh, I'm cutting a little close here, because I usually kill those slimes back at the start. Okay, and now the last one. Cliffhanger? What?
Fortune, look after your weapon and it will look after you.
Oh, another thing I didn't realize is while I was looking up like the deathmatch and stuff, most weapons really do actually change how they look when you when you ascend them. But it's the changes are so sometimes so minuscule. Like the deathmatch actually did change. It doesn't look like it used to when I first got it, I think. Yeah, it's got like red outlines on the blade, which were never there originally. So that's kind of interesting. And I only learned that because I was looking at the wiki. Interesting little commission here. Can you ask people where I forgot and that I left? Who's that cute person standing over there? I can't even see their front side and I'm just saying they're cute. Oh, it's a Fatui guard, but she's standing there so cutely. I miss winter time back in my own town. Well, I'm assuming we'll be there someday. Where is this other user?
I gotta sit
awkwardly with my blanket again to make sure it doesn't touch the floor and get all wet, because I don't want to sleep with a wet blanket. Ow, my an old man. Second to none. Whoops. Hey there. I don't know if I gave him the right one, but don't know why the game starts, like, chugging along whenever there's a lot of text on the screen that's forming. I got an achievement. I don't even know if I picked the right one. That's all, seriously? We didn't get an answer to- oh. Yeah, I think they wanted me to pick the right one from... of the two that I could choose from. I just thought I was gonna have to give him both, and then he would be like, oh, yeah. You know, that's where I left off. So I made a mistake there, I think. But it doesn't matter, you get your fucking shit for it anyways. And I got an achievement, so screw you. What is my achievement? Stone Harbor's Nostalgia, Series 1. Finish listening to the tale of the Wrath of Ding Dong and Cliffhanger. Ew. So I gotta listen to him again about the Ring of Raining Blades. In Cliffhanger, but the only way to do that is to get the Cliffhanger daily again. And that's like... You have to rely on chance. Imagine relying on chance in a gacha game. 34, that's my number. That's like my lucky number. Okay, let's go ahead and turn those rewards in. And then we've got resin that we can use, and then we can actually do something productive. How much time do I have here? It's 3:12, so... I'm gonna have to, like, ninja fight some bosses or something. That'd probably be better to ninja fight. Whoops, I didn't use Chunyung there. Well, it doesn't fucking matter anyways. Because I'll claim this stuff the next day. When they're all ready anyways. Okay, let's see if we can use our resin in time. Oh, that's to claim those. To use the resin in time, I need... Well, again, I didn't claim my freaking commission rewards. Why do I always do that? Thank you. How are we doing on Ganyu's stuff, by the way? She's still only level 8! Oh my tits! Jesus Christ, that takes so, like, long to grind! It's longer than anything else in this game! Okay, let's fight the Cryo Flower, because... I forgot what Ayaka needs. I think she needs those. I know that she basically everything she. Oh shit! This didn't reload yet. Respawn. I think she needs basically everything she needs is from Inazuma. So we're gonna be going back there because we are making Ayaka a character that I'm going to play. So no exceptions. But even like the weapons level up materials are in Inazuma. So everything's in Inazuma. So I have to go there. It's also storming, which is a bit weird. Because I can hear rain, but we're under a giant rock. Oh, shit. Why do you have to run out of... poof? What? I pick the best music for a boss fight with a giant ice flower. Oh shit, shit! Okay. It's on his face. Good. My shield broke right when he did that.
Come on, do it again.
Damn, almost.
I got it, bitch. I got it.
Ow. Well, she's below 50% health now. Oh, she didn't... Oh. She didn't hit me. Oh, boo. Fuck. Oh, now I'm just healing. Heal a little bit again. Just gonna do it because it does a little bit of extra damage for me. Okay. Get your little face down here. I targeted the wrong thing.
Yes, bitch.
Is this it? Last go around for him. Rest in many pieces, big ice flower. Give me that snazzy old shit. Let me just... I want to make sure that I'm... on track here. Okay, we still gotta defeat 5 bosses. I don't want to go over my weekly challenge so that I can do like the ley lines and domains at some point too.
Now what do we do?
We fought that. We're gonna fight the electro cube. And then I guess that'll be 80. And we can fight the rock guy and then the water guy. We just won't fight the fire guy today.